Hey friends, this is Scott. It is September 11th, the day of this recording, and a lot of people right now are celebrating the Feast of Trumpets, or what is called by the Hebrews, by the Jews, by Israel, Rosh Hashanah, which means the head of the year. They celebrate this. They have a couple different calendars, a civil calendar, which begins in the fall. They also have a religious calendar, which begins in the spring. Both of these time frames begin with festivals, which in Leviticus 23, God has put festivals, which that word really is moedim, and it is a word that means appointments. You got a calendar, you put appointments on them, and then you fulfill them. And an appointment means that two people at least meet together. And it's not random, it's scheduled. Well, our Creator has scheduled certain appointments to meet with mankind. And He's done this numerous times already. We can see this in the Old Testament as well as the New Testament. And more need to be fulfilled to finish up a timeline before Jesus has a 1,000-year reign called the Kingdom Age on this planet. Now, many Christians understand the importance of these appointed times, these appointments, these festivals, because they know that Jesus died at Passover, one of the appointments. He went into the grave on unleavened bread, one of the appointments. He came out of the grave, resurrected from the dead, the firstborn from the dead, on first fruits, one of the appointments. And then He sent His incorruptible seed, the Holy Spirit, to conceive in Jerusalem, Israel, inside of His disciples, a new creation, the body of Christ, which is now in gestation and has not been born from the dead. Paul calls Jesus our headship. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit inside of Mary. Let that sink in. The Holy Spirit conceived the Messiah, our headship, inside of a virgin woman, Mary. When He died, He was resurrected on one of the festivals. The same thing is going to happen to His body, the church. His resurrection on first fruits, at that time He became the firstborn from the dead. Resurrection is new birth. He was born the first time, corruptible, through Mary, with a sign in the heavens preceding it, no less. He was born the second time. He was born again from the grave. Our headship has been born again. But we are His body, Paul says. We have not been born again. But Paul revealed a mystery, which is still technically a prophecy because it hasn't happened yet, but it was prophesied in advance, given to Paul to reveal to us this mystery. It's called the rapture, which is primarily the resurrection from the dead of those who are in the body of Christ. And some who are alive at that time will simply be changed, incorruptible, and we will all meet in the clouds, incorruptible and immortal forever. Jesus Christ was born again, our head, and His body has yet to be born again. In a natural birth, in a healthy birth, a head is born first. The head comes out first. The body then follows. The body of Christ was conceived at Pentecost. The next festival to be fulfilled is the Feast of Trumpets. And so a lot of people believe, as do I, that the Feast of Trumpets is connected to the rapture of the body of Christ. The resurrection, primarily, and rapture of the body of Christ. As Paul said, that this event takes place at a time which is called the last trump. And he was speaking in festival language in 1 Corinthians all the way through the book. He said Jesus is our Passover lamb. He said Jesus is the bread of life, unleavened bread. Leaven represents sin. Sin is death. So if you have no sin, you are life. He is the bread of life. That's the Feast of Unleavened Bread. Just like bread goes into an oven and comes back out, Jesus went into the grave and came back out. Came back out on first fruits. Christ is called the first fruits of the resurrection. He is also called the firstborn from the dead. Resurrection is connected to birth. The body of Christ has not been born yet. And those who are in the body of Christ have not been reborn, because birth has to do with removal. those who receive Paul's gospel, the death, burial, and resurrection, he gave salvation to us freely as a free gift. Grace, we receive it through our faith. That's when we are reconceived, fertilized by incorruptible seed. When the Holy Spirit enters into us individually, we have a second conception. Conception is an entrance, but we haven't been born again because born again is a corporate activity of the entire body of Christ as one, as Paul says. We are all one in Christ Jesus. Chronologically, in Leviticus 23, the festivals are Passover, unleavened bread, first fruits, Pentecost. The next is the Feast of Trumpets, and then the Feast of Atonement, and then Tabernacles. The Feast of Atonement has to do with his second coming when his feet touch Jerusalem ground. And Tabernacles is when he sets up his kingdom to tabernacle with men, mankind, for his kingdom age, the 1,000-year reign on earth, as he taught the Jews, not the body, to pray for it. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come to earth, and thy will be done on earth as it is. His will is done in heaven. His kingdom is coming here. He promised it to the Jews. But first he has to remove his body to become one with it. Many believe, as I do, that's the Feast of Trumpets. So many are interested in, when is it every year? It's a holiday, technically. Just like on the Gregorian calendar, you have Easter and Christmas and such, they are reoccurring festivals that are rehearsed by those who take part in them. So are the Levitical festivals. They're rehearsals. They reoccur every year. The Feast of Trumpets comes every year. So how do we find it? Well, I'll tell you one thing we do. We ignore the Jews. They're blinded in part. We ignore their calendars. They don't understand how it works. Because the Feast of Trumpets was not revealed as far as how to find it on the calendar in the Old Testament. It's revealed in the New Testament, which they don't read. We have that information because we believe the New Testament. We certainly can't get saved without it. That's where Romans through Philemon is. That's where our gospel is. Paul's gospel, but the continued books give us more information as well. The Feast of Trumpets is in the New Testament. Happens every year. How do you find it? I'll tell you one thing. It's not in September of 2018. I'll show you how. I'll show you why. I just want you to know. I don't know if the rapture would be this year or not. I don't know if it's next year or the year after that, but I'll tell you one thing. You can find out when the feast is, when the appointment is, because it's written in the stars. Let's do this. What you're about to see is a massive fact of trumpets. We'll start from the beginning. Genesis 1:14, on the fourth day of creation. And God said, "Let there be lights in the firmament of the heavens to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons, and for days, and for years." This is when God, Jesus Christ technically, as all things were created by, through, and for him, he said that the lights in the heavens, the stars, the wandering stars which reflect light, the planets, the sun, the moon, the sun gives, the moon receives light and reflects. These were put for signs for humanity, those who understand his word, and for seasons, and for days, and for years. So also applies with months. The word month comes from the word moon. The word month used to be moonth. They took an O out of it. Moonth, because it's reckoned and calculated by the cycle of the moon. From the new moon to the full moon, back to the new moon. That's one month. So now the question becomes, which month are we looking for the Feast of Trumpets in? We find that in Leviticus 23:24, where God speaks to Moses and he tells him, "Speak unto the children of Israel, saying, in the seventh month, in the first day of the month, ye shall have a Sabbath, a memorial of blowing of trumpets, a holy convocation." So now we know that the Feast of Trumpets is on the first day of the seventh month. But what time of the moon is the first day of the month? We go to Psalm 81:3, where it says, "Blow up the trumpet in the new moon, in the time appointed on our solemn feast day." There's your time appointed. It's an appointment. It's a feast day. Blow up the trumpet in the new moon, which is the beginning of the month. So we've learned that God has created a calendar in the heavens, and he's using the sun, the moon, the stars to create a calendar, basically. And I've created a chart here to graphically illustrate as simply as possible how God has used, he uses the sun and the moon as well, from our perspective, to cut the year into four seasons: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. We have 12 months inside of the year. That gives each of the four quarters 3 months each for a season. So what God has done is he has created what's called equinoxes and solstices. And there's two each year of each. There's a vernal equinox, which begins the spring. There is a summer solstice, which begins the summer. There is an autumnal equinox, which begins the autumn. And there is a winter solstice, which begins the winter, going back around again to the vernal equinox, which is also called the spring equinox. Now, what we're going to do is I'm going to take you into an astronomy program, and I'm going to show you with even more detail how the sun moves across different ecliptic grid degrees to bring us to the actual beginning of each season. And a circle has 360 degrees. Now, if you cut that in four parts, you've got 90 degrees is the first quarter, 180 degrees cuts the year in half, and then you go around another 90 degrees and you're at 270, and you come all the way back around and you're at 360 degrees, which is also 0 degrees. So 0 degrees begins the spring equinox. This is when the night and the day time, as far as the sunlight and the darkness, are equal. Equa means equal, and nox means night. So equal night. This is when the day and the night are equal at this time. It's the same thing over here in the autumnal equinox. The summer solstice is when the days are longer and the nights are shorter. Sol, for solstice, sol means sun. Stis means stop. It's the day that the sun stops. It's the day that when the sun stops rising and it starts falling. In the summer, you have the sun is very high and you have very short shadows at noon, high noon, so to speak. The exact opposite is true. In the winter, you have very short days and very long nights, and the sun is much lower in the sky and you have long shadows. This is the first biblical month here. This is where Passover, unleavened bread, first fruits, and right towards the end of this, going into the third month, is Pentecost. You come around to the seventh month, and the first day of the seventh month, which is the first new moon after the autumnal equinox, which makes it a fall feast day. These are spring feast days in the green. The fall feast days are not in the yellow in the summer, they're in the red, they're in the autumn or the fall. These are the two seasons, spring and autumn, months 1, 3, and 7, where the seven appointments are. So how do you find the first day of the seventh month? Well, it has to be after the sun passes the 180 degree mark of the ecliptic grid. And it would be the new moon after the autumnal equinox. Let's go into the astronomy program and I'll show you that. What we're looking at here is the constellation Leo and the constellation Virgo. This actually is the beginning and the end of the year as far as the 12 constellations around the ecliptic. The ecliptic line is in the red here, and it is the line of which the sun travels perfectly on from the right to the left, and it moves through the constellations. The planets also follow this trajectory, but the ecliptic line is the exact line that the Sun travels through the constellations on. Now, we're focused here on Leo and Virgo, and at first glance, this might look very similar to what we've been studying and the amazing sign in the heavens of Revelation 12 that happened in 2017. However, these are just the fixed constellations. They're always there. What made that spectacular is the location of the Sun, the Moon, and the stars. What we're looking at here is a different time. It's a year later. This is 2018, September 11th, 2018. Now, if you can recollect everything that you've learned so far in this video, we need to look at the solstices and the equinoxes. Actually, we don't need to look at the solstices. We're just going to look at the equinox. We're going to look at the autumnal equinox, which we have learned is at the 180 degree location. Let me turn on the ecliptic grid. Okay, now the ecliptic grid is on. And this gives us the degrees of where the Sun and the planets will travel through, including the Moon as well. But we're specifically looking at the Sun because the Sun tells us when the change of seasons are, based on 0 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, and back around to 0 degrees, which is going to be spring, summer, autumn, and winter. Autumn is 180 degrees. On one side of that 180, it's summer, and on the other side of that 180, it is autumn. Right here, going across in the artwork here, and I'll actually turn off the artwork. Right here, going across the artwork of Virgo, the Virgin's head, up here you can see 180 degrees. This is the line that separates. To the right side over here is summer. When the Sun is in this quadrant over here, it's summertime. But when the Sun moves over into Virgo, it is always the fall, because this is the line right here. Matter of fact, this little marker right here is X marks the spot. That's the day when the Sun passes that, it turns from summer to fall. Now, I have right here the day. This is the day of this recording, 9/11/2018. You'll notice that the Sun is in Leo right now, but people are celebrating the fall feast days. That doesn't make any sense, because the Jews are telling people what time it is, and they don't know what time it is. They don't even know how to reckon the calendar, because they don't read the New Testament, and now it's time to read the New Testament. Revelation chapter 12 is the definitive way to find the Feast of Trumpets in the stars. It says, verse 1, and it's all you need, "And there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the Sun and the Moon under her feet." We can even stop there. The rest is a sign that happened last year. But the beginning of this sign, stopping at the comma, that's the Feast of Trumpets. The woman which we just looked at is the Virgin. This is depicting not only Mary giving birth as a virgin, but in the end times, this depicts the corporate situation of Jerusalem, Israel, the Virgin, giving birth to the body of Christ, who was conceived in Jerusalem, Israel. Virgo is the Virgin. It's the only woman on the ecliptic, and she is a virgin named Virgo, because God was in charge of the naming of these constellations. The woman clothed with the Sun is Virgo with the Sun in Virgo. That's after the autumnal equinox, and the Moon is under her feet. And I'll show you how that is the new moon beginning the month, which is also Tishri 1, or the first day of the seventh month. This is the definitive picture of how to reckon the Feast of Trumpets in the stars. So now we know how to create the Feast of Trumpets as shown to us in Revelation 12, the New Testament that the Jews do not read. We will put the sun in Virgo and the moon under her feet, and we'll find how this works the one day that it does take place in 2018. Today, the sun is in Leo in the summertime. If we move forward by the days, right here, this day, September 23rd is the day that the sun passes the 180 degree ecliptic grid line, and it's now the autumn. We continue and we wait for the moon to appear. Here it comes from the right. Here's the moon. October 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's the Feast of Trumpets in 2018. Now, if I take this to sunset, which in Genesis, it says that there was evening and then there was morning on the first day. The days begin in the evening, in the blue hour, after sunset. This is also when you sight the new moon to find out when the Feast of Trumpets is, or when any month begins. So let's take this to sunset. This is sunset on October 10th, 2018. When the sun goes over the horizon, the moon follows. And when the sun is out of your eyes, after it gets darker, when the blue hour fades, we'll zoom into the moon and we can see that light is reflecting off of the moon. Therefore, it is a new moon. New means that there is light on it. And when the sun is out of your eyes, it is said that two witnesses from the temple would have to agree that they've seen light on the moon, once again beginning a new day, a new month, and a new year. When the moon passes the sun and goes into darkness, the month dies. When light is seen on the moon once again, the month is reborn. This is the resurrection moon. This is the first day of the seventh month in 2018. Not September. October.